Initially, I didn't have any plans to do any sequels to any videos, but ever since I started listening to the Sonic Gems Collection Games menu song, I got stuck in a trance of thought, just thinking nonstop on how this song in particular can inspire me because I really liked how it sounded. And then it hit me. Games menu music. Because within that menu of the game, there are games. Games. Let me talk about games. Let me talk about my favorite type of game, but not about the technicalities of it, but simply how it inspires me and many others, particularly the platforming genre. Hell, even games with platforming elements, it all applies, at least to me. You see, I grew up playing a variety of games, but the platforming ones always stuck out to me more, just because of the fact that when you start up the game, it's time for an adventure. Some are good, and some are temporarily bad. Some are just flat out bad, and the others are just not your cup of tea. Looking at it from all angles, they've brought something new. You've learned from them. You either learn more ways to progress further in your endeavors, you learn what steps or actions not to take as you move forward, or you simply turn down what you're not interested in. What does running, jumping around, and eliminating those who stand in your way have to do with what I am saying? Well, each of those games handles their conflicts differently, just like humans, hence the examples I mentioned. And if you think about it from one perspective, the platforming genre is all one. All of the platformers we know of the past and today are all unified. They're all tied to one genre, which is platforming. But within the genre, all of these games are different in their own ways. Everyone knows this. However, thinking on a philosophical level here, the covers of the games and the content that these games provide for us helps us understand the game more, just like how we need to get to know people to then make a judgment on that person. Remember when I mentioned that some of these adventures are good, temporarily bad, flat out bad, or are just not your cup of tea? Yeah, the people that we meet in life are also either good for us or bad for our lives. They have issues that need some fixing because no one is perfect, or we see and get to know them temporarily. They come and go. Games come and go, aka we play them, then stop playing them for a while, if not forever, and they could come back to our minds, or we can go back to them whenever, or we find new games. Sounds very familiar, right? Just like humans, generally, we get to know people. Sometimes we get to know them for good, sometimes we don't know them for long, or we never get to know them at all. However, not knowing them at all or getting rid of those people out of your life has now opened up spots for new people to come into your life. Because you can't hold on or accept those that don't care about you, that see you as futile, or has a toxic grip on you forever. It's just not natural. This leads into my next point, the resurgence, or comeback if you will. As you all know, the platformer genre has had a resurgence for about 2 to 3 years now as far to my knowledge, so I'll just briefly state things for new games as well as for games from franchises that we're familiar with. Starting with Yooka-Laylee, it was alright. It tried to leave the same charm Banjo-Kazooie had, but more so dragged it instead of having its own identity. Shovel Knight's undoubtedly dope. Shantae came back after about 5 years, overall just some time, and did well for the most part. Ratchet & Clank returned, but didn't necessarily have the same magic as its first game did in the past. Crash came back, giving to the people as to what they wanted, and succeeded for the most part. Sonic Mania remained true to its past glory, while bringing a couple of new things here and there to keep things fresh. A Hat in Time looks great, heavily inspired by Mario 64 while still keeping its own identity and being ambitious for what it's going for. And Mario Odyssey looks phenomenal. There's a heavy amount of growth with this in comparison to the other Mario titles. The reality of all eight of those predicaments vary, while very subjective, proves my point. Those exact games are reflective of humans. The only difference is that I can play these games whenever I please. The only job these platformers have is to keep me distracted from any negative thoughts and keep me immersed in the universe that I am accompanied by the protagonist as well as the other characters while I'm on their journey. That's the easiest job a platformer can do, especially for a lone wolf like myself. And that's why I love platformers.